Welcome, guys, and welcome to ILTACON 2021. I'm here with Jigsaw and the best booth babe I've ever seen. Would you guys introduce yourselves?
Yeah, my name's Kalisha Leon, and this is Bosley.
And I'm Travis Leon.
This entire interview will be directed at Bosley, at the structure. So tell me a little bit about Jigsaw. You are not new to legal tech, and you're certainly not new to ILTACON and to ILTA, but we're excited to talk a little bit about that roadmap. So let's start off. Where did you guys begin?
I guess it started, I was originally a lawyer. I practiced at Linklaters for several years. And my business partner, Stephen, was also a lawyer. And we used to discuss all the time the issues we had with legal practice, how there were much more boring elements of the job than we'd ever really imagined when we went to law school. And there must be better ways to do a number of the tasks that we were partaking in. So that kicked us off with our very first legal tech venture, nearly 10 years ago, actually. It was called XREF. It was our first venture into the world of entrepreneurialism, and we knew nothing about legal tech whatsoever. And I remember our very first ILTA, we had no idea what this was. I knew it was in Vegas, so I was pretty keen to try it out, but it was a whole other story to how it is now. I mean, we were just stopping people on corridors and trying to speak to people at lunches to just try and get a foot in the door. It was pretty tough. People didn't know us, we didn't know them, we didn't know how anything worked. But eventually, after a lot of graft, we kind of got our foot in the door. And we managed to grow what we'd like to consider a fairly successful business, which was eventually acquired. And that gave us a really nice foundation for looking at our next projects, other things that we could change in legal, and that brought us to Jigsaw.
I like the story about the first ILTA where you had to beg to be allowed to come.
Yeah, that's right. Yeah, I contacted ILTA at the time, and it was Ken. I don't know if you guys remember.
Yes.
Ken was he's the person who picked up the phone and then dealt with us ever more. And I mentioned, we're a startup, we don't really have much money, and we don't know much about legal tech, but we really have heard, we want to come to the conference because we've heard good things about it. And he was like, to be honest with you, at this late stage, if you're not going to have a booth and you haven't got much money and you don't know what you're doing, you probably shouldn't come. And we're like, oh, okay, that's interesting. And then the next day we're like, well, Ken, we've thought about it. We still want to come. could you maybe give us a discount because we don't know what we're doing and we're very poor? And he was very kind, actually. And he did give us a bit of a discount, which was helpful. And when we got here, it was a nice guiding light for us, giving us a little bit of instruction and just sort of helping us through the whole process and giving us some tips and tricks on how to best navigate ILTA. Which was exhausting, actually, but yeah, it was fun and it was extremely successful from our point of view as a business.
Your first ILTA Con was in Las Vegas, and we're in Vegas again this year. Can you tell me a little bit about the differences between that first setup and this booth setup?
Yeah, the first time I was saying we have to go out there and just force people to listen to us. So we were like rugby tackling people in the corridors. We were trying to think of inventive ways to get people to stop and come to the booth because a lot of them have an agenda and it's like, I want to see this vendor, this vendor, this vendor. Nobody knew who we were. So we had to force people to listen. This year we've got people coming and hunting us down. We've got CIOs that have been told, come and look at Jigsaw. It's a great tool. People are getting really excited. And even though it's a little bit quieter this year, we've still had a queue of people trying to get involved and see Jigsaw. It's been really good.
Well, then let's be very specific here. The reason people are coming to the booth is for the service, not the dog. Just checking. So let's talk a little bit about Jigsaw. Tell me exactly if I was a good Word document user, but very different product here. Talk to me about it. What's Jigsaw?
I suppose if we start with kind of like general trends in society, if we want to be a little bit vague, everybody's moving towards consuming more visual content. People
yes.
like to watch video, they yep. like to look at pictures. So the idea of trying to work out what's happening in a legal transaction, for instance, by reading pages and pages and pages of text and documents, it's not that appealing to clients. So that's kind of where it begins. So a lot of lawyers, not just lawyers actually, but business professionals who are in banking, accountancy, consulting, they are all trying to find better ways to engage their clients, and they often will draw up diagrams, essentially, visual representations of what exactly is happening, not just to help with their clients understanding, but also to help themselves understand exactly what's going on. I mean, a lot of these deals and transactions and cases are becoming ever more complicated. And the best way to understand complicated information is usually visually, and diagrams are at the moment the sort of the best way of implementing that. So jigsaws, a quick and easy and attractive way of creating these diagrams, rather than, I mean, currently people use PowerPoint, which is antiquated, hasn't really changed for like 20 years. Anyone who's tried to create these things in PowerPoint or even Visio, they'll realize it's very painful, it's not enjoyable, and the output is not particularly attractive. So that's kind of, we identified that from our experience as
certainly
lawyers.
I'm a heavy PowerPoint user, and it's sometimes difficult to get the point across. It's a good tool, but it's also a difficult tool if you're looking still the best studio guest ever, if you're looking for a way to get that point across quickly. And the quickness seems to be the accessibility here. We're mm-hmm. talking about making something visually appealing and understandable. And I think it's that comprehension piece that is really drawing me to it. If someone wanted to obviously stop by the booth and get a demo, they could. But you guys have something a little bit extra online. You can reach out directly, I understand, and get a personalized demonstration.
Yeah, absolutely. We definitely prefer to have that personal touch. We can talk to somebody about their diagramming needs, get a bit specific, and tailor the demo to them. So rather than just having a video, you know, on the website that's a little bit impersonal, we can have a conversation, and it is a visual tool, so we want to be able to share and show you visually how we can help you.
And if you happen to be here in person, what we also have at the booth is you have the opportunity to use Jigsaw. We have a little competition where there's a diagram that took about 30 minutes to create in PowerPoint, and you see how quickly you can create it in Jigsaw to win a prize. And the record at the moment is 27 seconds.
Yeah, we've been surprised at how quick.
That is incredibly quick. Is there a prize just on my end for the slowest to make that work? Because I would be that.
We can come up with something. We have some swag, maybe a hoodie or a bag for you.
Excellent.
I think you'd surprise yourself at how quick you are. We've been really shocked.
Or I could break the computer. There's really only two ways this could go. I'm excited for the ability to do something that is much more appealing for us to continue to get the message across to clients and to other firms. It's got to be hard out there. There doesn't seem to be a fast way, and you guys look like you're finding that.
Yeah, it's been amazing, and what I didn't realize was that there was nothing out there. When Travis spoke to me about the idea in the first place, I was like, surely there's got to be something out there that does this already.
Sure.
And obviously they've done their market research, there isn't. And after using Jigsaw for so long, I've kind of gotten complacent. I went back into PowerPoint a few weeks ago and I was like, how do people do this? It was so frustrating.
Yeah, I mean, we've had comments like that from a bunch of lawyers that we work with. I mean, these are often partners, and they say things like, this is going to change my life, or this would have saved 6 months of my past,
sure,
you know, few years of practicing. They get pretty excited. One guy said, you're nearly bringing me to tears, when he just saw how much easier it was when he was trying it out versus, you know, the time he spent in PowerPoint, often at weekends and late at night, and that's when people are conducting these types of tasks.
If you would stop watching what I was doing last night, that would have been great, because that's really what I was doing. I'd like to talk a little bit more about what's next for you guys. From the innovation standpoint, you guys have been innovators throughout this, from your very early journey and roadmap to now. What's kind of coming down the pipeline for you?
We have a bunch of exciting features. We've got probably, I'd say, a two-year roadmap,
okay,
already like very planned out in detail, with new features, new functionality. The idea that you can visually represent whatever you're working on, there are different nuances and ways that we can apply that to different practice groups. Simple things like litigators often use timelines.
Mm-hmm.
And that's something we didn't initially anticipate. I wasn't a litigator. Steve, my business partner, wasn't a litigator. But that's been coming back to us. There are things like steps papers, which are like presentations, mm-hmm, essentially, that tax teams will often be creating, or people who work with private equity funds. And these things are really quite complicated, quite lengthy. And everybody, again, is creating these in PowerPoint. It takes hours and hours and hours. So creating a better, quicker, and more attractive way to produce those, again, that's something that people are very much looking forward to.
I think it's important to say we've had a really collaborative approach to the roadmap. We've worked with a lot of firms under what we call the Jigsaw Consortium, where they're actually feeding into all of the features. We don't want to have something like PowerPoint where it's one tool fits all, but not quite,
static.
You know, you're making it work. We know that there's specific features and functionality that are going to make people's lives a lot easier. And so we're having those conversations with the clients every day about, you know, what do you need and how can we make this better for you?
That is a perfect segue into, we'll have a part two of this where we can talk more demos and see some additional pieces once we come back from ILTACON. Thank all three of you for joining me. And I'm really looking forward to getting a demo because I'm, A, the worst PowerPoint user live, the slowest, and my drawings are terrible. So any help I could get. Thank you guys for joining me.
No, thank you very much for having us here.